I'm David Mason, the Director of Public Health for the Town of Sandwich, and I'm also the Program Manager for the implementation of the Water Resource Management Plan. And in the past, I've done a number of different educational videos ranging from wastewater to COVID to the ponds. But today, I want to talk to you about Know Your Water Supply and where it's coming from and the background information on that, how it's regulated. So the first is that, you know, you're either in the town of Sandwich, you're either served by a private well or by water from the Sandwich Water District. Now keep in mind, the Sandwich Water District is not part of the town government. Legally, they're a separate entity. They do a great job. They do a fabulous job of providing a great product at a very reasonable price if you compare the gallonage rates throughout the state or even the country. They do a great job for the money that you pay for water. And they're very responsible there. And then as far as the private well, there is no oversight or operator of a private well. You, the owner of the private well, are responsible for that well and really trying to keep track of what's going on with it. A lot of people get their private well tested when they first build a house or when a house is being purchased, and usually not in between. And the problem too is even if you tested your private well and there was found to be some issue, is, you know, your solutions or ability to solve a problem with that well relative to quality of water is limited because you're using one water supply in the water. So you have to look at a level of expensive filtration or maybe having a new well put in that's even deeper at this point. So in town, there are 10,000 structures that exist in town, and of those 10,000, like 7,200 of those structures in town are serviced by the Sandwich Water District, and it's about 2,800 structures that are serviced by private well. And you know, so the information I want to convey to you today is one, what the source and quality of the water is coming out of your tap. The regulatory oversight of that water, and the process to obtain water from the Sandwich Water District. Now, forgive me, I have notes because I have some very detailed information I want to provide you. So I want to make sure I don't leave anything out. So let's talk about the source and the quality of the water. Today, I have a sample from a private well that I pulled today from a friend of mine's house, and we'll pour it. It looks nice and clear as far as it's not murky or anything like that. And then we have the Sandwich Water District. And the Sandwich Water District, the quality of the water is overseen by DEP, the Department of Environmental Protection. And there's certain guidelines they have to hit and meet and testing requirements that are required in order to operate the water system. So there's a lot of oversight for the quality of this water. Because if you look at this water, it looks the same, but what's in it is totally different. So some of the issues that are occurring is that that as far as that regulation, from the state for the Sandwich Water District has resulted in additional testing that they need to do. Specifically, what's been in the news is PFAS, or polyvinyl chlorinated, polyfluorinated substances. And additionally, there'll be more testing in the future for what's called contaminants of emerging concern, or COCs. So the regulatory oversight, you know, as far as what's in your water here, you know, if you're on town water, they know what's in your water, and they know what needs to be addressed in your water, be it coliform, iron, manganese, and PFAS. With the well water, you only know if you're testing it yourself, to the extent that even if you tested it for PFAS, which is very expensive also, whether or not it's there, once it's identified, because you're on a private well, there's not a lot you can do. There's some very expensive filtration that's available for that, but it's not, you're not testing your private well with the consistency that the Sandwich Water District is testing their water supply. So I'm starting to lay this out to you, the importance of having water that comes out of your tap to be a consistent quality with a regulatory oversight. Granted, you know, people love wells. I had a well at one point in time that I was like, well, it's, you know, I'm not paying a water bill. Well, you pay. I mean, you pay for maintenance and operation. If that well fails, you're looking at a minimum of $10,000 for a new well. And if you find something in that well that's not right, it needs filtration, you're just paying for some expensive filtration. Also, when the power goes out, you don't have any water. So you're out there filling those jugs or buckets to get through that storm. So the regulatory oversight for the PFAS is required by DEP. Again, sorry for my notes here, because it is showing up in our water and it's showing up throughout the Cape, and PFAS is from common products that we use every day. You can look that up and you'll see, you know, what type of materials it exists in. You have it in your house now. And when every time you wash an article or something that has PFAS, there's some of it moving off of that material into the water that you have. So how do you guarantee a safe water supply? And this is really the point of the communication today, is a lot of people and those who are on the private wells, the 2,800 that I spoke to that are on private wells, are not aware of the information or of how to proceed to get Sandwich Water District into your area of town. And on their website for the Sandwich Water District, there's some very specific directions on how that is done. You basically need to petition, you and your neighbors need to petition the Sandwich Water District to be included in the district and petition them to expand the water lines into your area. And it's a process that once you do the petition, it takes some time for design to allow and construction to bring it out there. So this is something you need to be, you know, aware of also, that if you're looking for town water and you're interested, one, there's a process. Two, it does take some time to get it out there. So what I want to show you though too is there's up on the map that I have here, there is the area of the water district that is in light blue. And there's two circles, red circles. And those are the areas of town that are served by private well. And those are the areas that we're looking, that we feel, or I feel, that there is a need to expand the water lines in order to provide you a safe, potable water supply for the future. So again, in order to find that information for the process, to initiate a petition to the Sandwich Water District, you're going to go to sandwichwater.com. So with that, sandwichwater.com has all the instructions on how to proceed. If you have questions, you can give their office a call. They're very helpful there. Again, I cannot say enough of good things about the Sandwich Water District and the service they provide and the professionalism of the people there. But I want to bring to your attention that your well water, you don't know what's in it. And as far as what contaminants are occurring and contaminants of emerging concern and the inability to really control your personal private water supply from your well can create problems in the future. And the way to go is through a public water supply, which will provide you a safe potable water supply that is regulated by the state Mass DEP to continue its protection. And the water district wants to provide that also, because that's their number one mission. Thank you for watching.